All right, just give a little insight into how we can look at power curves in rowers. And if we look at a chart here, this is in a lightweight four, and this is a power curve of each person in that particular boat. And as you can see, each of the curves are somewhat different in each of their applications. This is the catch, this is the finish. All right, and you can see that some apply the power later in the stroke. Some apply the power early in the stroke, and the fall off from the power in the early in the stroke is that it comes off towards the end. What you're trying to achieve is a good bell curve, similar to this one. Whilst this one probably hasn't got overall strength, the movement of the curve is fairly full in this process. That's handy information for a coach. So, in how we set up a boat, who rows in what seat. I'll take an example on the whiteboard of how we may look at who rows in the bow or in the stroke of a pair. You would look to see if someone rows in the stroke seat of a pair would have quite a quick force curve, so their catch would be quite sharp and build, and then they would try and hold out in the second half of the stroke. That would be the strokeman. The bowman would probably not be as dynamic as a stroke, but would have a good second half power phase and build through the stroke. The idea of that is that the bowman, he puts his blade in and he holds the pressure against the strokeman as he applies that sharp power. And then in the second half, he's able to provide ongoing power. Not only because the bowman is closest to the bow of the boat, and the strokeman is closest to the stern of the boat, the biomechanics of how to move a pair, that's the most efficient method.